Hey, it's Fran, again, with another installment from the factory. This time, I wanted to highlight my workbench, because a lot of people have been asking about the workbench, and I've talked about it kind of briefly in other videos, and I tweeted about it back when I used to do social media stuff, but I really thought that the bench really deserves its own video, because it is such a marvelous, spectacular workbench. So this framing bench, table, whatever you'd want to call it, it's a shaker version of a French framing bench. It's kind of unique. It dates back to the 1880s, 1890s. It was purportedly made in Philadelphia, and so it is sort of a shaker style. It has an unusually sturdy base to it. It's made in two pieces. The top table portion is just sits down onto the base with some pegs that actually go up into the upper part of the table, and it's held there just by gravity. The whole bench is solid old growth maple, and the top, just the table top, weighs well over 100 pounds, like 120 pounds, so just gravity keeps the whole thing together. It's got these wooden screws, and even though it has suffered some damage from power tools, as you can see, the threads on the screw have been kind of gnawed off on one side, but it doesn't really affect the vise. It still works just fine. And the bench has sets of these dogs, which are little wooden pegs with sort of a springy side to them, a little leaf of wood that's sort of attached to the dog sort of at an angle. And these are used to set in the registered holes in the bench to allow you to clamp down a really long piece of wood. And, I'm going to put one in the end vise here and show you what I mean. There you go. That's how that works. And because the dogs are adjustable, you can clamp down a piece of just about any size, and so it really makes it a framing table. The end vise is very versatile. It's probably the most useful vise in the bench because it'll hold down a flat piece very sturdily, and you can use it to do cutting and chiseling of objects that are that you need to work on the ends. And also, it'll hold a piece of wood really securely so that you can do trimming and working on the sides. So, yeah, the end vise is it's definitely the most versatile. I use it more than the other sort of side vise for most things. Another great feature of the framing bench is the tool tray, this recessed area in the bench where you can lay in all your hand tools, saws, chisels, stuff like that. And my planes, and I, you know, a lot of purists will say, oh no, you never lay a plane down on its face, but as you can see, I have blocks in there, and I set up the planes on blocks so that I can have them sort of in the position that I prefer, and you don't mess up the blade. Another cool feature this bench has is a planing stop, which is this little thing on the end here which you can flip up, and that allows you to just put a plank of wood on the bench right up against that and then plane it. It's just a handy little tool to do quick things and when you don't want to have to clamp something down. Planing stop. So as I said, this is sort of a Philadelphia shaker style bench, and it has these iron reinforcements in it that go through the bench and really give it a lot of extra sturdiness. And on the bottom too, those iron screws. I did have to tighten them down a little bit when I got the bench finally in place in the workshop. But they really do make this bench uncommonly robust. And some views of the screws and that screw block. It's all handmade, hand carved. Just remarkable. The underside showing the more unused surfaces. And the one thing about a bench like this is all of the mojo that comes with it. You get all of the scars from 140 years of work, paint cans and varnish, and you can see here where one of the owners preferred to put their cigarettes on the very edge of the tool bed. And it's just all this mojo. It's what I love about the bench. It's just all the histories right there. And the great thing about having a bench like this is you get to add to it. So as I use the bench, I add my signature to its history. And like Neil Young said in his song about the guitar, this old bench is mine for a little while. Well, that's it about the bench. Fantastic bench, made in Philadelphia by who knows who. But it is quite marvelous. Thanks for watching. I'm Fran. I'll see you around real soon. Bye!